Hear ye, Judge Shirley Ranaldi is arriving to court. Stand up and rise. Stand up.
Come to order. You may be seated. The plaintiff in this case, please stand and say your name.
I'm Lorene, and I'm here to get half of my money back from this gentleman who was supposed to be costumed in a Buzz Lightyear costume for my child's birthday party, and he only wore half of the suit, and he wore his underwear for the other half. Therefore, I am entitled to half of my money back.
How old is your child?
Five.
Oh, my. Okay, let me hear from the defendant in his defense. Say your name, sir.
My name is James Casey. I was sent to the party by my company office, and I was certain that I had all my paraphernalia and clothing and everything for the party in the car. And the mistake I made was that when I got there, it was too late to go back when I found out that what I needed for the costume was not in the car.
Did you know before you left that you were supposed to be this character, Buzz Lightyear?
Yes, in my yes, report. Yes.
And how much notice did you have in advance of this gig?
2 days.
Well, so you had a lot of time to prepare.
Yes.
But you screwed up. How much did this lady pay you?
$250.
She paid it to you?
No, she paid it to the company.
The company?
Yes.
Is there a representative here from the company?
Yes.
Let's have the representative please step up. Ma'am, state your name and occupation.
Lillian Loring from the Diamond Lil Enterprises.
And
we are a company that supplies entertainment for children, clowns and different characters.
So you booked this arrangement?
Yes, Your Honor.
And you had this gentleman to represent the company.
Yes, he's worked with us for many, many years, and he's very good at his job.
Did you receive full payment from the mother of this child?
Yes, we receive payment before he goes on the job.
Before it happened. Okay, and then you sent him. Does he imbibe any spirits?
He does have a drinking problem, yes, but that was not the problem in this case.
How do we know?
Well, for one thing, he did show up at the party, and he did put on his costume, and he did his entertaining, and the children were happy.
Were you there at the party?
Pardon?
Were you at the party?
I was there part of the time, yes.
Were you there when he arrived?
No, I was there later.
So did you notice that he was at all influenced by any drugs or alcohol?
No, he was not. He was perfectly capable of the job that he was sent to do.
You may be seated. Thank you. Sir?
Yes?
What were your actions immediately before leaving in your car for this party? Did you have anything to drink that morning?
Yes.
When did you load your car for this party? When did you actually put your things in the car?
As I recall, it's a day or two ahead of time.
Ahead of time, and you still didn't remember the bottom part of your costume.
Apparently, I overlooked it.
So what did you do when you discovered that you were at the party and you had no pants?
Well, I thought I'd just play it by ear and play it the best I could.
Which is what? How did you do that?
I had most of the costume. The only thing I had to do was put on an outer set of underwear.
Over the, what, your legs?
Yes.
That's it, your bare legs?
Yes, yes, yes. This character normally comes
in. Oh, you came in front of the children in your underwear?
Yes, well, boxer shorts.
Oh, my goodness. All right, you may be seated, sir. May I speak with the plaintiff again, please? Ma'am, what do you want because of this mishap?
I want half of the money back, and I want all the pictures destroyed because they were not boxer shorts. They were the other kind, and they...
Briefs?
They, yeah. And they had stains on them.
Oh, my goodness. In front of the children.
And he smelled of liquor.
Oh, my goodness. All right, so I think, sir, that your case is kaput. You have no defense. Were the children upset? Were the children in shock, or?
I think maybe one little boy was traumatized.
Oh, my. All right. My verdict is going to be that you do get half of your money back, which is $125.
Thank you, Your Honor.
And an extra $25 for the children. So you get $150 back. And, sir, you need to get a different job. That's my order.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Hi, I'm Tillie, and I'm from Channel 3, and I came here to interview you on this situation.
Oh, yes, I won. Did you notice I won? I won, and the judge even gave me extra because of this pervert.
Yeah, but you're still dealing with these children, right, that were there?
Yes, one mother claims her little boy had to see a psychiatrist, but I'm not sure if that's true.
Are you happy with the way this turned out?
Oh, yes, yes, very happy.
Very good. Thank you.
Thank you.
This is Tillie. My name is Tillie, and I'm from Channel 3, and I came here to introduce you, and because you were the child that was traumatized, could you tell us what your name is?
My name is Zelda.
Zelda, and you are the lady that had the party.
That's right.
And your name is?
Lorene. And this is the child that's seen a psychiatrist.
I'm very upset. I can't sleep at night. I'm so scared to go anywhere. That man over there, he scares me.
How did he scare you?
Well, he kind of like had these little teeny underwear pants on. Very scary. Oh my God.
You poor thing.
I do think we're going to sue again for drama and trauma that happened to her, because these psychiatrist bills are going to be very high, but that'll be another case.
Oh, it's just horrible.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon. I'm Tillie, and I'm from Channel 3, and I came here to interview you on this latest trial that just came up.
Do you have any questions?
Yeah, what's your name?
Howard.
Can you tell me a little bit more about it? Because we talked to the child, and they could sue you, you know.
I saw that, and the child is not a 5-year-old.
Really?
She's a 21-year-old. Short person.
Oh, my dear.
Very short. Playing. But I thought I was being sent to an adult party, not children's. So it didn't matter. Sir, I didn't have all my costume, but I didn't think it mattered in an adult party. I thought it would make me more of a blast than anything.
Well, this really must have shocked you then.
Yes, to a degree. But I'm all right to take care of those kind of things. It's within my mind to be aware of the situation and play it by ear. But I don't think that the judgment should have went that way.
Okay. Thank you. I'm Tillie, and I'm from Channel 3, and I came to introduce you to the situation here. Your name is?
I'm Lillian Loring, and we have the Diamond Mill Enterprise, and I just want to set the record straight.
Okay.
I got the phone call from the stripper that I knew, and it was her 21st birthday, and she said she wanted her fiancé to the party as a surprise to her guests and everybody, so I sent him over. So we were all in on what was going on. And to ask for anything else, it's wrong. She was not traumatized. She was surprised. No way. She knew. She's the one that I talked to. She's the one that made the arrangements, and the Speedo outfit was part of a bikini, and he was supposed to have done a high dive, and that didn't go off. I don't know what happened, but it didn't happen, but that's the story.
Okay, but how about the money that she paid you? Are you reversing, giving her that money back?
No, she got what she wanted.
But she got a joke is what she got.
That's what she wanted.
Oh, okay. This is Channel 3. My name is Tillie. And I understand, Judge, that you were really upset over this.
Well, I was lied to. It doesn't make any sense. After I've already passed judgment, and I based it on what I was told, and under oath in the courtroom, and then they come up and accuse this woman of having a grown-up party with a stripper, and nobody was traumatized. So I would have made an entirely different judgment there. This is outrageous. It really is. The man is considered now for the court a pervert, and he's not, apparently. And the agent that sent him there was doing her job, and the woman who was the plaintiff apparently left out a whole lot of her story, half in her sworn statement. So I can't be... I should sue them. Thank you.